Okay, so we talked about some of the differences. Now let's talk about what happens if you don't obey those rules. I remember about, this is probably 6 or 7 years ago now, when we were first starting Reddit, there was a program online called Basecamp, and it's made by a company called 37 Signals, and it's used for organizing to-do lists and stuff. And so the page kind of looked like this. You had like these, you know, to-do items. And next to each of these to-do items was a little link that said delete. And this was just a link. And if you recall, normal links with the anchor tag that you would see and click on, those make GET requests. To make a post request, you need a form. And these were just links. And so if you were logged in, you could create these to-do items. And if you wanted to delete it, you could just click on delete. Well, there was another program out at the time called Google Web Accelerator. And what that was is it was a browser plugin that would sit in your browser. And while you're browsing, you know, let's say this is your, you know, the browser you're looking at. Let's add a picture here. You know, while you're browsing a bunch of text, you know, there might be some links, you know, throughout the document. The Google Web Accelerator would make those requests behind the scene, you know, so that when you click the links, the pages were ready to go. The problem is the Google Web Accelerator was hitting these links. So users would go to their, you know, Basecamp page, look at their to-do list, and find that their items were deleting on their own. And that's a that's kind of a big problem. And that's what happened, or that's what happens when you use GET requests to alter the server state. Those guys at the time just assumed that since we were logged in, you know, no bots would ever hit the page. You know, it would only be users clicking. But you know, if your browser is behaving funny, or if you've got a plugin running that's you know, clicking on all of the links for you, you better be certain that those links don't actually change the server. So what you should design instead is, instead of making, you know, links that alter the server, you can make little forms. And the form can just have a little button in it that says delete, or it can have a special link that causes it to submit the form, but it should be making a post request.